Right. So let's get into the topic. So now the next system is about endocrine system. Endo means inside, crine means secretion. So secreting inside the blood means directly into the blood, we call it as endocrine system. So directly into the blood, the secreting system is nothing but glandular system. So all the endocrine glands will secrete chemicals. The chemical we call it as hormones. Coming to the first, why do we need a hormones? Hormones will control our body chemically, because nervous system will control our body with electrical stimulus. Likewise, endocrine system will control our body with chemicals. And that chemicals we call it as hormones. Hormones will actually regulate our metabolic rate. What is metabolism? Means some of all the reactions, all the chemical reactions in our body, we call it as metabolism. So the chemical reactions by time, we call it as metabolic rate. It will increase the time or it will decrease the time. Water and mineral balance, such as how much amount of the water should be there in our body. For example, if we have excess amount of water in our body, that leads to the condition called hydrolysis, means death because of water. Or else, if the water content was lost, then we call it as dehydration. And next, mineral balance. Minerals means sodium, potassium, chlorine, magnesium, calcium. All these mineral amounts are also maintained in our body. For example, if calcium got increased, we call it as hypercalcemia, which is very tough. Even below the calcium levels, we call it as hypocalcemia. So likewise, it differs. And immune system reactions. So our body's immune system, like T lymphocytes, are being activated by thymosin hormone. And sexual functioning, mainly the female reproductive system and male reproductive system is fully supported by hormones only. So coming to the organs of endocrine system, we have adrenal glands. Adrenal means adding to the kidney. So it was present on the top of the kidney. And next, ovaries. Ovaries, we also call it as gonads. So because that will act as the primary reproductive organ as well as so releasing the eggs. So ovaries will release the ova and testes will release the sperms. And pancreas. So pancreas, the pancreas, pan means all. Creas means secretion. It will secrete both endocrine as well as exocrine. So in the pancreas also, the region we call it as islets of Langerhans. That part alone will secrete the endocrine hormone. Remaining part of pancreas will secrete exocrine hormone, exocrine enzymes. And parathyroid gland. So these glands are present nearby the thyroid. Para means near. And pineal gland. Pineal gland is present in the brain. Pituitary gland is also present in the brain. So I'll show you in detail. And next, testis. Testis, we also call it as gonads. And thymus gland. Same alanti the level. Okay. And thymus gland, which is present in the chest region. By this age, we don't have the thymus gland because it will already degenerated. And thyroid gland, we all know it was located in the neck region. And let's see the gland one by one. In this picture, you can see in the brain part, we have the pineal gland. And this is pituitary gland. We call the pituitary gland as master gland. And this is thyroid. And nearby the thyroid, we have parathyroid. And this is thymus, present in the chest region. And this is adrenal gland, present on the top of the kidney. And this is ovaries. And this is testis. So this both we call it as gonads. And this is pancreas. So pancreas means it will release both the type of exocrine and endocrine secretions. So let's see the combining words, what we use related to the endocrine system. And acro. Acro means extremities. So our hands and legs are the extremities of our body. So that's why acro means extremities. Adreno means adrenal gland. Adrenalo is also adrenal gland. Andro means male, for example, androgen, male producing. Calco is calcium. Crino means secretion. and estro means female, like andro. So estrogen, female producing. Glyco means sugar. Glycoso is also sugar. Gonado is sex glands. Ovaries and testes are gonads. And homeo means same. Cal means potassium.
So
kalemia is potassium. And natrium means sodium. In Greek, natrium is sodium. Ophthalmo means eye. So ophthalmology means study of eye. Pancreato is pancreas. Parathyroido, which is parathyroid gland. Pinealo, which is pineal gland. Pituitaro, which is pituitary gland, master gland. Thymo is thymus. Thyro is thyroid gland. Thyroido is also thyroid gland. Toxico is poison. And coming to the suffixes. Crine means to secrete. So endocrine, secreting directly into the blood. Exocrine, secreting out of the blood. For example, we have the salivary glands, which secretes the saliva outside the blood. For example, if you want to collect any hormonal levels in our body, so what we usually do? If I want to go for a thyroid check, then... Hello?
Yeah.
So where do we collect the thyroid hormone?
Blood test?
Yeah. Because those secretions are directly released into the blood. So, and for example, if you want to know the thyroid stimulating hormone, which is released by the pituitary gland, then we have to go for a blood check because these release the secretions directly into the blood. And if you want to go for an exocrine, then you can collect it outside the blood only because those secretions are not released into the blood. Sweat we can collect outside the on the body itself. Saliva we can collect it from mouth. So likewise we have gastric juice, we can collect it from the stomach. So we have two different types of glandular system. And dipsia means thirst. For example, if the patient is diabetes mellitus or diabetes insipidus, there is a condition. So in mm-hmm. that condition they'll have too much thirst. We call that as polydipsia. So continuously the people will be telling they are continuously having thirst and continuously they will be urinating. So we call that condition polyuria as well as polydipsia. Both the things will be there. Frequent urination will be there and frequent thirst will be there. Prandial means related to the meal. For example,
postprandial.
Mostly the diabetic sugar test was being taken, glucose test was taken, PP, postprandial. So there you can see this nomenclature. After the meal. Preprandial means before the meal. Tropin means to stimulate. So let's see about the anatomy and physiology part. So endocrine system is nothing but collection of the glands. So the glands will secrete the hormones directly into the bloodstream. And through the blood, it will go through the target organs. So for example, if oxytocin was being released by pituitary, but it has to act. So this hormone was usually released at the time of delivery. If this hormone was released only, the mother pregnant woman get the pains, or else the pregnant woman will not get the pains. So when it was been completing the full term, when the mother or the woman goes to the hospital, the first injection was oxytocin to induce the pains. So it will go to the target organs through the blood and it will increase or decrease the activity level, target activity level. So it won't start anything. Hormones will not start anything. It will only control the rate and speed and instrumental in maintaining homeostasis. Homeostasis means so the amount of water, the amount of chemicals like calcium, potassium, sodium, these things are maintained in a level in our body. And finally, it will maintain the stable internal environment. Types of glands. So as I told you already, there are two types of glands. One is exocrine and other one is endocrine. Exocrine, we also call it as duct glands. Duct means from the gland, we have a tubular extension. that tubular extension will release the secretions outside. So wherever we want to release the secretions, from there it will. So all the exocrine glands are duct glands, but endocrine glands are ductless glands because it doesn't need any tubular extension. It releases directly into the blood. Example for exocrine glands are sweat glands. Any other glands, you know, exocrine. Any other glands other than sweat glands? Salivary gland is an exocrine gland, as well as sebaceous glands, the oil secreting glands.
Oil secretion, okay.
And lacrimal gland is an exocrine gland. It produces the tears. At the same time, mammary gland is an exocrine gland because that gland will release the milk.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the exocrine glands. And endocrine glands, we have a number of examples for endocrine glands. So coming to the number of glands, adrenal glands are 2 in number because we have 2 kidneys. Parathyroid glands are 4 in number. Pancreas is only 1. Pineal gland is also 1. Pituitary is 1. Ovaries, we have a pair of ovaries located in the pelvic region. Testis, we have a pair of testes located outside the body in the special bag-like structure called scrotum. Thymus is also 1 gland. Thyroid is also 1 gland. Let's see the very first gland, adrenal gland. So these are the kidneys. On the top of the kidney, we have this gland. So this gland is adding to the renal. So that's why we call it as adrenal gland. So it was divided into 2 parts. So this outer region, we call it as adrenal cortex. And this bluish color, purple color region, we call it as adrenal medulla. The very simplified thing, like outside, we call it as cortex, whether it was a bone or any other thing also. Inside, we call it as medulla. So that was a common nomenclature used for the outer regions and inner regions. And in this picture, you can able to see clearly, this was the right kidney and this was the left kidney. I already told you, right kidney will be a bit lower. So the adrenal gland was located above the kidney, and that was along the kidney. That's why even the adrenal gland is also lower than the left side. And this is the left kidney, and this is inferior vena cava. And this is abdominal aorta. And this was the cortex. And this is adrenal medulla. So the hormones released, we call it as corticosteroids, because it is released by adrenal cortex, and the hormone is made up of lipids. So whatever the hormone, if it is made up of lipids, then we call it as steroids, because it is made up of the chemical called sterol. That's why we call it as steroids. Sterol is nothing but fat. So secreted by adrenal cortex. And these hormones, we call it as steroid hormones. These steroid hormones have 3 types. One is mineralocorticoids, which controls the minerals. In that name itself is there the meaning. Glucocorticoids, which control the carbohydrate metabolism. And steroid sex hormones. Even as a woman, we also secrete the testosterone. For men, they also secrete the estrogens because of this adrenal cortex only. So some men will behave like a woman because they'll have excess amount of the steroid sex hormones, female sex hormones. And first group is mineralocorticoids. So the name of mineralocorticoid hormone is aldosterone, and it regulates the sodium and potassium levels. And glucocorticoids, so we call it as cortisol. And it regulates the carbohydrate metabolism. And, because it's named it as cortex solution, cortisol. So usually, if the person was in highly tensed situation, he need more amount of glucose in the blood, because more amount of energy should be generated. At that time, the cortisol will play key role for generating more amount of sugar. Steroid sex hormones, androgens, which are male hormones, estrogen, female hormones, and progesterone, pregnancy hormones. Progesterone, gestation means pregnancy. Progesterone, that was released prior to the pregnancy. That's why they called it as progesterone. and regulates the secondary sexual characters. Secondary sexual characters means voice, body type, breast development, development of beard and mustache in males. So these are all characters. So by appearance itself, we tell they are male or female. That we call it as secondary sexual characters. Observable characters for both males and females. And inner portion. Inner portion is adrenal medulla. It only secretes two hormones, that is epinephrine and norepinephrine. So when you are about to run a race or about to run a marathon or you are about to write an exam, then that time, these are the hormones which will increase your heart rate, which will increase your breathing, blood pressure, temperature, availability of glucose, everything. So even at the time of exam, you don't have any, you don't have enough energy also. You will gain it like a Superman. That is because of this epinephrine and norepinephrine. So we also call it as adrenaline or noradrenaline. So that was very critical during emergency situation. It will increase the vitals. Vitals means blood pressure, heart rate, and respiratory rate. Next, ovaries. There are a pair of ovaries located in the pelvic cavity of females. They secrete female sex hormones, that is estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen are responsible for female sexual characteristics and regulation of menstrual cycle. Progesterone means that will prepare the mother for the pregnancy. And it will provide a stable environment in the uterus for pregnancy. So here is the picture of ovary. So we call this as gonads because that will release the egg as well as that will produce the estrogens, means female sex hormones. At the same time, progesterone also. Progesterone was being released at the more amount of progesterone is released at the time of pregnancy. But some amount of little amount of progesterone are released during the menstrual cycle. Pancreas. Pancreas was located in the lower abdominal region. So near below the stomach, we have this pancreas. This is the pancreas. So it has both exocrine as well as endocrine part. Exocrine part will release the digestive enzymes directly into the GIT. So directly into the duodenum. And endocrine secretions are released by islets of Langerhans. Islets means island that looks like an island, separate island. And Langerhans is the scientist who discovered it. It will produce only two hormones. One is insulin, other one is glucagon. So insulin will decrease the blood sugar level. And glucagon was quite opposite. That will increase the blood sugar level. So insulin was produced by beta cells. So in this islets of Langerhans, we have two types of cells. One is alpha cells and other one is beta cells. Insulin will be produced by the beta cells. And that will stimulate the cells to take the glucose into the cells. So that's how it will decrease the blood glucose. And it usually increases the insulin release after the meal. And glucagon. Glucagon was being produced by alpha cells. So that stimulates the liver to release more amount of stored glucose in the bloodstream. Whatever we eat, so the excess amount of glucose or excess amount of fat is being stored in the liver in the form of glycogen. And whenever we need the glucose, that will be released from the liver. So that work is done by the hormone called glucagon. And this is the picture. Here we have the liver and this is the pancreas and this is the stomach. It was underlying below the stomach. And in this picture, you can able to see this is the exocrine part of the pancreas. This will release the digestive enzymes into the duodenum. And this is the islets of Langerhans. And alpha cells and beta cells. Alpha cells will produce glucagon. Beta cells will produce insulin. Insulin will decrease the blood glucose. Glucagon will increase the blood glucose. Parathyroid gland. We have four tiny parathyroid glands. So this is actually the parathyroid glands, this green color part. And that was located on the backside of the thyroid. And parathyroid gland will actually regulate the blood calcium levels. When the blood calcium levels was too low, then what it will do is, it will go to the bones. And there it will stimulate the bones to release more amount of calcium in the blood. That's how it will increase the blood calcium levels. And in this picture, again, you can see this is the throat. And this is trachea. And this is thyroid. And this is parathyroid. Okay. And pineal gland. So pineal gland was like a small pine-shaped gland. Small cone. That's why they named it as pineal. Here we have this pineal gland. And this was a part of thalamus, the sensory relay station. And that will produce the hormone called melatonin. So what the melatonin will do is, it will maintain the circadian rhythm of our body. Circadian rhythm, we also call it as 24-hour cycle. For example, if you are taking a breakfast by 9 o'clock, by 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, again we feel hungry. Means it takes around 4 to 5 hours of time. Again, we have to, our body is stimulated to take the food. So if we work for 8 hours per day, after 8 hours, our body will feel to take rest. After taking rest, at night, by 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, we feel sleepy. So by mid of 3 o'clock, it will be very sleepy. So this whole cycles, we call it as circadian rhythm. So the 24-hour cycle was being maintained by melatonin. And next, pituitary. So this was the pituitary, the master gland, which is a small marble-shaped gland. So located beneath the brain, it was divided into two lobes. In this picture, you can see that. Anterior pituitary and posterior pituitary. So this even this pituitary will control the all the glands. That's why we call it as master gland. But even this pituitary gland is controlled by some other gland, which we call it as hypothalamus. So it's like a headmaster. Even the headmaster itself will have a control over the correspondent. Likewise. So anterior pituitary, we call it as master gland because it controls the all the other endocrine glands. For example, it will release the hormones called thyroid stimulating hormone. That thyroid stimulating hormone will control the thyroid gland. Adrenocorticotropic hormone. That will control the adrenal cortex. Gonadotropins. Gonadotropins, we have two hormones. Follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. Follicle stimulating hormone is responsible for the development of ova and sperm. And also stimulates the ovary to secrete estrogen. So luteinizing hormone will stimulate the sex hormones. So that will, luteinizing hormone is very important during ovulation. The ovulation means release of egg. So for women, one egg will be released per menstrual cycle. Means approximately for 28 days, one egg will be released. That is mainly controlled by luteinizing hormone. If the luteinizing hormone releases, then only the ovulation will happen. Because of the problem with the luteinizing hormone, then only their menstrual cycle will be extending. Growth hormone. We also call it as somatotropin, which will increase us the height, control the height of our body. Prolactin, that will stimulate the milk production from the breast. Melanocyte stimulating hormone. So that will actually stimulate the melanocytes. Melanocytes are the cells which are located on our skin. So that will maintain the body color by producing the pigment called melanin. So you can see in this picture. So this is anterior pituitary, the master gland. So it will produce the hormones called thyroid stimulating hormone, which will control the thyroid gland. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, which will control the adrenal cortex. And prolactin, the breast, follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. We call it as gonadotropins and testis also. In males, it is testis. In females, it is ovary. And growth hormone, which is for the elongation of bones and soft tissue. Posterior pituitary. The posterior pituitary will produce only the two hormones. One is antidiuretic hormone. The name itself is there. It will prevent the diluted urine, formation of diluted urine. It will act on the kidneys to reabsorb more amount of water from the urine. So that's how our urine will be concentrated. Oxytocin. Oxytocin is released at the time of labor to increase more amount of uterine contractions. So that's how the baby will be delivered out of the body. Testis. These are the two oval glands located in the scrotum. that will produce the hormone called testosterone. Testosterone are males will maintain the male secondary sexual characters and regulates the sperm production. So this in this picture you can able to see this is the testis. And these are seminiferous tubules. So this inside this tubules only we have the sperm production. Thymus. Thymus was located in the mediastinum. This center of the chest we call it as mediastinum. So there the thymus gland is there that will produce the hormone called thymosin. So that is for the activation of T lymphocytes, thymus activated lymphocytes. That is very critical part of body immune system. So which is present at birth and grows to largest size during puberty. At the when the puberty begins to shrink and eventually replaced with connective tissue and adipose tissue. So by this time we don't have the thymus. So till the puberty it will grow well and it will activate the T lymphocytes. Then it will shrink its size. So this was the thymus gland which is located in the mediastinum. Thyroid. So thyroid gland is present in the neck region on the trachea. So which is a butterfly shaped gland. We have two lobes. This is right lobe, left lobe. And the center part we call it as isthmus. And thyroid hormones are two thyroid hormones. One is thyroxine T4 and triiodothyronin. The number of iodine molecules will depict the number. T4 means 4, T3 means 3. It needs iodine to make the hormone. And these hormones will regulate the energy production and adjust the metabolic rate. And thyroid gland will produce one more hormone called calcitonin, which is quite opposite to the parathyroid hormone. Parathyroid hormone will increase the blood calcium level, but calcitonin will decrease the blood calcium level, which is quite opposite, like insulin and glucagon. And this we call it as Adam's apple. This thyroid cartilage, Adam's apple, this is very prominent in males. And this is thyroid gland, right lobe and left lobe, and this is isthmus. Coming to the word building part, adrenal. Adrenal means related, pertaining to the adrenal gland. Adrenomegaly, enlargement of the adrenal gland. Adrenopathy means adrenal gland disease. Adrenalectomy, removal of the adrenal gland. Adrenalitis, inflammation of the adrenal gland. Hypercalcemia. Hyper means excessive. Calco means calcium and emia related to blood means excessive amount of calcium in the blood. Hypocalcemia, decreased amount of calcium in the blood. Endocrinologist, so the specialist about the endocrine system. Endocrinopathy, diseases to the endocrine system. Hyperglycemia, excessive blood sugar level. Hypoglycemia, low blood sugar level. Hypokalemia, excessive potassium levels in the blood. Hyponatremia, low sodium levels in the blood. Parathyroidal, pertaining to the parathyroid gland. Parathyroidectomy, removal of the parathyroid gland. Hyperparathyroidism, a condition of release of excess amount of parathyroid hormone. Hypoparathyroidism, a condition of insufficient amount of parathormone. Pancreatic, pertaining or related to pancreas. Pituitary, pertaining to pituitary. Hypopituitarism, a state of low pituitary. Hyperpituitarism, a state of excessive pituitary. Thymic, pertaining to thymus. Thymectomy, surgical removal of the thymus gland. Thymitis, inflammation of the thymus. Thymoma, thymus tumor. Thyromegaly, enlarged thyroid gland. Thyroidal, pertaining to the thyroid. Thyroidectomy, removal of the thyroid gland. And hyperthyroidism, a state of excessive thyroid. Hypothyroidism, a state of low thyroid. So let's see the vocabulary part. Are you comfortable till here?
Yes.
Okay. We'll see the next part on Monday because it will be too clumsy. Okay. Till here, if you are having any doubts, let me know.
That's all clear. Thank you.
Okay. No, ma'am. No. Venkatesan? Hello? Venkatesan, are you there? Okay, I'll share you the PPT. You go through the vocabulary also by today or tomorrow.
Sure.
So for your vocabulary part,